The story of Passover begins with Moses walking in the desert and seeing a burning bush. But somehow the bush is not consumed by the fire. Moses is drawn to the bush, and God then gives him the mission of taking the Jews out of Egypt. Why the burning bush? Why is Moses' mission to bring out the Jewish people connected to a bush on fire but not getting consumed? I want to share a story with you about Glenn Cunningham. Glenn was born in Kansas in 1909. When he was 6 years old, he and his 9-year-old brother Floyd were given the job during the winter months to light the fires in the school stoves so the rooms would be warm by the time the teacher and the other students arrived. One very cold morning in February 1916, the two boys loaded up the large stove with wood and then soaked the logs with kerosene, as they always did. But that morning, something went terribly wrong. Floyd struck the match, he dropped it in the stove, and there was an explosion of fire that engulfed Floyd in a sheet of flames. Someone had mistakenly filled the kerosene container with gasoline. Floyd died from his terrible burns, and the doctors told their mother that Glenn would likely not survive due to the devastating burns on the lower half of his body. But to the amazement of his doctor, Glenn survived. But the fire had destroyed his motor ability. His thin legs just dangled there lifeless. Glenn was confined to a wheelchair with no use of his lower limbs. His mother refused to let the doctors amputate. Glenn refused to accept the verdict that he would be a cripple. He was determined to walk. Every day his mother and his father would massage his little legs, but there was no feeling, no control, nothing. But Glenn wouldn't give up. One day his mother wheeled him out into the yard to get some fresh air. Glenn threw himself from the chair and pulled himself across the grass, dragging his legs behind him. He worked his way to the picket fence and raised himself up. And then, stake by stake, he began dragging himself along the fence, resolved that he would walk. With iron determination, Glenn did this every day until he developed the ability to stand and then to walk and then to run. With sheer joy, he ran everywhere he could. By the time he was 12, he had beaten all the local high school runners. Later in college, he had made the team, and he was nicknamed the Kansas Flyer. In February 1934, in Madison Square Garden, this boy, who was never expected to survive, who would surely never walk, who could never hope to run, this boy ran the world's fastest mile. Like Glenn's doctors, Moses looked at the Jewish people and saw how badly burned they were on the outside. He saw how terribly abused they were in Egypt, and he assumed that they would never be able to regain their faith. There was no hope. But the Almighty chose the burning bush to teach Moses a crucial lesson. Sometimes in life, something can seem so badly burnt on the outside, but inside, it's still very much alive. Don't give up on the Jewish people. One of the underlying messages of Passover is to never give up on anyone, no matter what. Never give up on an elderly parent in the hospital. Believe that they can recover. Never give up on challenging relationships. Believe that they can be repaired. Never give up on your marriage. Believe that love can be recreated. Never give up on your children. Believe in their talents. Believe in their desire to do good. Never give up in life. Believe in yourself. And never give up on the Almighty, because He believes in you. Happy Passover.